Welcome. This is Mr. Travis 779 with New and Old. Today is Thursday the 1st of December. And tomorrow is a big day. Tomorrow the RV comes home. Just out here, I wanted to do a quick video and check to make sure everything's prepared. Me and my mom, we're going to go down tomorrow and take a drive to Dallas, Oregon. It's about a 2-hour drive. Towing might be a little bit longer, but that's okay. You can see here we have got the driveway, which is in very good shape. I was having some carburetor issues with this Ford. I'm going to start it up here, let it warm up, and see if I can get this sucker to run okay. I was adjusting the carburetor on it. It's having carburetor issues again, and you know, as much, you know, I have nothing against carburetors on non-emission motors, hot rods and stuff are really cool. They're really fun, but when you have an old truck that has an emission motor, I don't know, I am not a big fan of carburetors on these older trucks, but when they work, they work. So let's warm it up here, because in order to adjust it, it has to be at operating temp. Did fire up okay, which is good. Did fire up okay. Right now the choke is on, so it's got to get up to operating temp. Very cold-blooded. This Ford is very cold-blooded. I'm hoping it cures itself once it gets going. Yeah, it's choking itself pretty heavily at the moment. I think I'm going to invest in a couple cans of seafoam next pay period. Invest in a couple cans of seafoam. Maybe that might clear it up a little bit. I don't think it's carbon buildup, because when we took the heads off about 4 years ago, it wasn't that bad carbon buildup wise, is what you expect a normal motor to be. But over the years of not having the world's greatest, I mean, this has got an Edelbrock carburetor on it. We got a good carburetor, standard 650 CFM carb. It had the stock one on, the Holley. Well, it was Motorcraft, but it was actually a Holley. But, and that one kind of worked. But it wore out. It just simply just wore out. It started leaking in a whole bunch, and it just wore out. So we updated to a newer one. To a Edelbrock aftermarket conversion, which works really well. I mean, there's nothing wrong with them. Great for hot rod use, but for this emission motor, it's... When I do a motor on this truck, if I ever can afford it, it's gonna get a hot rodded 460 in it. It's gonna have a lot of power. Gonna get a good 460 engine. It'll cost me about $5,000 to have one built, but that's gonna be a good 460 engine. Long ways down the road though. This truck still has a lot of life left. I think what's gonna kill this truck is the transmission. But the transmission's in pretty dang good shape. I mean, we had it at service, the module went out on it once. It's a CC6, a three-speed, which are, I mean, those are bulletproof transmissions to begin with. So, I mean, it works pretty good. I mean, those are pretty good, dang good engines. So, see what we can do. It's warming up now. The choke's coming off. Well, let's see. Let it warm up here for a few minutes. Just let it run in at high idle. Get it good and hot. So I'll get back to you when it gets warmed up. Oh, so Mr. Travis 779, it's just now starting to warm up, and according to the gas gauge, it lost about half a tank of fuel. I don't think that's right, but it's still running like crap. This is a typical carburetor. Let's open up and see. Still cold, so hoping it cures itself. Yeah, the thermostat hasn't opened up yet. But it is running. So I think it'll be okay. Once it really starts towing and really starts working. It's a little shaky. Definitely not running right. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some seafoam in it once it warms up to operating temp. I'll put some seafoam in it. I have a little bit of seafoam. I don't think it's going to make much of a difference, but I think this is carburetor. I'm going to dump a little bit of seafoam down the rear tank. Let's go ahead and get that. I'm going to dump a little bit of sea foam here. This is the sea foam. Well, we could. Okay, well, let's try this. Let me set you guys down here. Set you guys down in the motor. And I will start this engine. And it is basically operating temperature. According to system.
Okay. Now that's supposed to be turned off. And it's supposed to dump the rest in the tank.
Grab you guys. So we're going to wait for 15 minutes. Let the seafoam take effect. Let it cure all the gooblies and goblies, or whatever they call it. And then we'll go from there. So time is 1:37. So at 1:50, we'll start it back up and let it run. We'll see you then. Well, this is Mr. Travis 779. I'm back. I'll probably make this into a one-part small video. Trying to see if we can get the idle to work better in this truck. Unfortunately, it's just the carburetor. You know, it's just the way some of these trucks run. Now, granted, if I had the money and had the funds, I would stick about $5,000 into this motor and rebuild it completely and take off all the unnecessary equipment and made it work for me. But unfortunately, if I had $5,000, I would probably also buy a fuel injected truck. So yeah, it's kind of one of those things, you live what you live and your means, you live in your means. And with the RV, I can't afford a truck payment and an RV payment at this time. At least until I get some few of my bills paid off. But we're just waiting here. Still got a few more minutes. Should be ready here shortly. Let's go and start it up. It's about that time. Well, let's fire up. And yes, it is doing what it is supposed to be doing. Smoking up a storm. Smoking up a storm. Yeah, you can see that. See it in the back. Seafoam's working. Okay, let's take it for a little test drive. Let's see if we get some heat going. Now we're gonna have to turn the defogger on. See if it did what it was supposed to do. Well, I don't know. I've got I don't know, I've got mixed feelings. Can definitely feel it's still cold in the pedal. But I do have mixed feelings. It does. If you look at the gauges, or doing about 35-40, and I think this can tow. Well, anyway, it's got a tow. It's the only thing I've got. Gotta take the chance. I think once we're on the freeway and cruising at 60 miles an hour, I think we'll. I think we'll be okay. Having to give it a lot of gas, though. Having to give it a lot more fuel to get up and go. That's strange. Having to give it a lot more fuel. Definitely having carburetor issues again. You know, this truck does this every year, though. It always has carburetor issues when it gets colder out. Let's see here. It seems to. Doing about as good as you would expect it to. Yeah, I think this will pass. I think this will pass. I can still feel it choke a little bit. It's not exactly perfect. It's not exactly key. Let's throttle it. Throttled it to 4,000 RPM, and guess we'll find out. We gotta drive it down to Dallas, Oregon tomorrow, so I guess we'll find out. I guess that'll be our next video of getting the RV back and hoping we don't have any breakdowns along the way. Because that would suck. Yeah, you know, to tell you the truth, knock on wood, this Ford has never left me stranded. Come close a few times, but it's never left me stranded. Well, I think this ought to work. Anyways, this is Mr. Travis 779 with new and old. I'll go ahead and post this and this and this video, and then we will, like I said, today's the first, tomorrow's the second, and is when I get back the RV, and well, tomorrow is when I get back the RV, so until then, y'all have a good one. Take care.